This is a Friday Shoes production. This is lesson 4-9 in our books on page 232. And the target is I can solve problems involving similar triangles. It's also called indirect measurement. What is indirect measurement? Well, that allows you to use properties of similar polygons, and today we're going to be using triangles, to find distances or lengths that are difficult to measure directly. Let's look at the example here. It's called shadow reckoning. And the example we have is a fire hydrant and a street lamp. It says a fire hydrant is 2.5 feet high and it casts a shadow of 5 feet. How tall is a street light that casts a 26-foot shadow at the same time? Let H represent the height of the street light. You can see the picture there. See the shadow and you see the height of the lamp is actually H. That's what we're trying to find. But I want you to recognize that they're actually, when we have shadows, we're actually creating a triangle. That's in red there on both of the fire hydrant and the lamp. And it has the measurements that we have there. So this should bring you back to what we've done before, where we use similar figures and we had proportional sides. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to set up a proportion where we take the shadows. In this case, we're going to take the 5-foot shadow of the fire hydrant and the 26-foot shadow of the lamp, and we're putting it as a ratio, 5 over 26. Now, of course, we're going to take the 2.5-foot height of the hydrant and match it up with the height of the lamp. That's our other ratio. Once you have that set up, you remember what to do. All we have to do now is cross multiply and solve, because you know that the cross products are equal. So we have 5 times H and 2.5 times 26. And that equals 65 on the right side. And then we end up dividing by 5, and the height of the lamp is 13 feet tall. How about you give it a shot here? Pause the video, try this one. Draw yourself a picture. Come on back, see how you did. All right, here it is. At the same time, a 2-meter street sign casts a 3-meter shadow. A telephone pole casts a 12.3 meter shadow. How tall is the telephone pole? Step one is drawing yourself a little picture so you can see what's going on. So I've drawn a sign and a telephone pole. And I put in the information that they've given. They said that the sign is actually 2 meters tall, but it casts a 3-meter shadow, and the telephone pole casts a 12.3 meter shadow. So how tall is that telephone pole? Well, let's do what we did this last time. Let's take the shadows and make them in ratio. So we'll take the small and relate it to the big, or the sign and relate it to the telephone pole. Those are the shadows. You can see that's generated there. And then let's take the height of the actual sign and the height of the telephone pole and put it over as our other ratio right here. And of course, cross products and solve. And when you do so, you get that telephone pole is going to be 8.2 meters tall. All right, you can also use similar triangles that do not involve shadows to find missing measurements. I call it the triangle within a triangle. Here's the indirect measurement method in this case. It says, in the figure at the right, triangle DBA is similar to triangle ECA. Raymond wants to know the distance across the lake. Well, he's got some information, and all that's going to be very helpful, where we actually don't have to stretch over this lake. We can actually just use the triangles to figure it out. First of all, can you recognize a few things? We have two triangles in there, don't we? One of the triangles is that smaller one. Another one is the larger one. And guess what? These are similar, meaning sides are proportional and the angles are the same. So let's put in the information that we know. We know that this and this blue one, this is 320, and we know that this is 40. We also know this length, the long red triangle, which is 320 plus the 162. So 320 plus 162, we got ourselves 482. Right there. And now we can find out what our D is going to be. And here's what they do for us in the book. They do exactly what we've done there. They've related now. 320 relates to 482, their corresponding sides. And then 40 relates to D. Those are corresponding sides. And then, of course, they've solved. And we have that the lake has a measure of 60.25 meters. How about you give it a shot here? Why don't you pause the video and try this one. Come on back, see how you did in comparison to what I did. All right, find the length of Kentucky Lane. Well, Kentucky Lane, I can see the two triangles in there. Can you see them? I made them a little bit more visual for you. All right, so we've got, let's see if I can drag this one out of here. No, they're not going to let me go. Well, you see that blue triangle. We have 4 miles right here, and we have 6 miles right here. And then the red triangle, which is a lot bigger, we have 8, because that's 4 plus 4, and then we don't know what this is, what distance this is. These are both going to be right triangles, by the way. So we can compare. We can say that the distance of that hypotenuse relates to the hypotenuse on the other in blue. And then we come back and say, well, then the 8 goes to the 4, because those are corresponding sides. And then we solve using our wonderful cross multiplication. Oops. So we have 4 times D is equal to 6 times 8. That's 48. We divide by 4, and D will equal, how many times does 48 go, or 4 go into 48? 12. So this is actually 12 miles. Don't forget, you can always come back and rewatch the video. And you can read the examples in the book again if you like. Or you can check out some of the personal tutor videos they have online with our textbook. And as usual, this has been a Friday Shoes production.